nasty man, no offense, Jovi.
No, tell me what the Quran is.
The Quran says,
what
you understand. From what I understood, first you advise them. Then you talk to
them. That's John chapter.
And then
no, that's not what the Quran says. The Quran doesn't say that.
Yeah.
Okay, that's the second one.
Okay. It doesn't say beat them.
Oh,
it doesn't say beat them. No, it doesn't say beat them.
What is it?
Miswak. Stroke.
Why?
Just to be
So, you advise them?
You advise them.
You leave
but
them
there's another translation of Ibn Kathir. He says the translation of Udrubuhun is not beat them, it's leave them.
Okay, which translation are you taking?
I'm taking leave them.
Why? Because you're comfortable with that.
Udrubuhun means strike. Go on strike.
What I'm saying is, if the Quran clearly says, gives you three options, advise them for saying them and beat them.
It doesn't say beat them.
That's what the Quran says. We just read it.
Yeah, but there is another translation that says leave them. Strike.
Okay, so how many Qurans do you have?
There's another ayah.
But two different meanings.
No. Yusuf اضرب عن هذا. Yusuf اضرب عن هذا. It doesn't mean Yusuf hit that. اضرب عن هذا means leave it alone. But اضربوه means leave them. So you talk to her.
Then you daraba. The Arabic word is daraba.
Yusuf اضرب عن هذا. اضرب means leave it alone.
434 says daraba.
Yeah.
Which means beat them.
No. There are many translations. The Arabic language.
Okay, so I thought it was one Quran you have.
We have one Quran. The word daraba. The word daraba, not the Quran, has different translations. The word daraba has different translations.
Arabic, every word has 100 meanings.
No. There is no
100. Don't fight.
He's my little brother. He's 15.
I'm joking.
But the thing is, Yusuf, اضرب عن هذا. اضرب means leave. So, what it says is, you advise them. And then you talk to them in bed. Then you leave them in bed. And then you leave them. Like, leave them for a couple of days.
You don't touch them.
No, you don't touch them.
But it says that, though.
It doesn't say
why does it say it
and
when
that
we read it
that you brought up? It was just like,
okay, brother, if I give you that, why cannot a woman do the same thing to a man?
Why is the problem in Chichiga?
Wait, I'm talking to you. Why doesn't the Quran command a woman to advise the man if he's disobeying her? To leave him in bed and then beat him. Why is it only to man, but it's not talking to women?
If we're gonna do man, then
you know
woman,
what I mean?
Man, then woman, the Quran wouldn't be 600 pages, it would be 6 million pages.
It doesn't matter though, there's gotta be equality.
There is
so
equality.
If the Quran is to man to advise the woman and do everything, what about a woman, a man who disobeys his wife? What about him? What happens to him? By who? But what about his wife? His wife doesn't do anything, so there's no equality. What does she do? According to the Quran, she can't. Where in the Quran does she
can't? I've not memorized the Quran by heart.
It doesn't matter, you don't need to memorize it. But do you know it's in the Quran? Which surah?
I don't.
It doesn't say.
But you know, we have.
It doesn't happen.
I know some people who have been left by their wives and by the court of law, which is follows the Sharia law. She has successfully left him because
Sharia law.
Yeah,
law doesn't say if she's successfully leaving him by Sharia law, she's disobeying Sharia law. The Sharia law has got because no rights for women.
No, come on.
No rights at all. Give me one right a woman has under Sharia law.
Many rights.
Just give me one.
What do you want? Ask me.
Any rights? Any rights to a man? Any rights in government? Any rights in society? What right does a woman have compared to a man?
The Prophet Muhammad's first wife was a successful businesswoman.
What's her name?
Khadija.
Okay. I'm saying to you, in the Hadith and the Quran, where does it say a woman has rights in society? Yeah, give me a surah.
Also read the whole Quran. Read the whole Quran.
I haven't seen anything.
No. Read the whole Quran.
I haven't seen anything.
What have you seen?
Because it's not there. I can't read it. I'm reading.
Work. They can't do anything. What can't they do?
Sorry?
What can't they do?
They're submissive to their husbands completely.
In the Quran, is not mentioned any woman except Mary. Mary is the only one that is actually mentioned in the Quran. So why is that?
and
why is that?
Huh?
Why is that?
They mention lots of Muslims.
Which one? But
this is a generalization. If you talk to Ayyuhal Mu'minun wal Mu'minat, Tayyibun wal Tayyibat, there are many ayahs.
Name me one woman.
Let me read a
Quran. One woman is mentioned in the Quran,
yes,
besides Mary. One woman.
No, no, he's right.
There's no woman. There's no woman name.
No, no, he's talking about name of the woman. I'm talking about women in general.
For example,
Maria.
Maria of all women doesn't need to mention like many individuals.
For example,
gives you an idea how important the women were. It gives you an idea.
No,
yes. They were not important for them at all.
For example, a woman is seen as stupid in the Quran and the Hadith. Okay, check out the Quran, Surah 2, 282. We'll read it together.
Yeah.
And then I'll give you a Hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari, where you can also read in Arabic. Yeah? So I'll read Surah 2, which is Surah Baqarah, Ayah 282. Yeah? This is why it says in English. Have two witnesses from among your men, and if two men are not there, then one man and two women from those witnesses whom you like, so that if one of the two women forgets, the other one may remind her.
Which ayah you said?
Ayah 282. So it's talking about here a woman forgetting. So the other woman will remind her whatever she's forgetting.
Breathe upon clay and that clay become in life. Now,
did you get it? And then I'm gonna show you the testimony of a woman. It means nothing compared to a man. Can you imagine?
Testimony has to be three women against one man.
Three women.
Two.
The higher number.
It's considered a woman to have half of a brain of a man. Half of a brain of a man.
282.
No, you got the chapter. 282.
Yeah. That's the higher. 282.
Okay.
You said it right. 282.
Got it? Yeah.
Do you have Sahih al-Bukhari on there as well?
No.
Okay. Sahih al-Bukhari says in volume 3, book 48, number 826, narrated Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, the Prophet said, isn't the witness of a woman equal to half of that a man? The woman said, yes. And then the Prophet said, this is because of the deficiency of a woman's mind. Deficiency means the woman's mind.
That hadith you mean? Naqsat aql wadin?
Sahih al-Bukhari, volume 3, yeah. So how can a woman be stupid?
You mean the definition of the definition of naqsat adl wadin?
The deficiency of her mind.
You mean
her mind is deficient. That's what the hadith says. So it's degrading women. It's suppressing them.
What do you mean? You're talking about the hadith. Then
I said it's degrading.
It's also
deficiency.
Man, explain
it to me.
All right. I'll tell you what. The reason for hadith. Then
are you going to hadith or?
I'm going to the hadith. We know the ayah.
Okay. Yeah?
The shahada, it's just saying that in order the shahada, two women, because if one forgets, another will remind.
But yeah? Do you know that a woman never forgets?
No, don't say never. Don't say never.
Compared to a man,
no,
women remember things more than a man.
Don't say never.
Do you know that?
No.
But let's put that to the side.
I have a good memory. I don't know about
it. Compared to women, you don't. Trust me.
Some women,
anyway, go on. She remembers what you're wearing, what you are holding, everything.
Exactly. Women remember important details.
Exactly.
Yeah, right, we are more efficient.
I don't. Right. I'm glad I don't have to remember so many things.
Yeah, we got the woman today for us.
But when it says in the hadith, naqsat aql wa deen, it means that in naqsat deen, it means that when she gets her period, the woman is exempt from praying and exempt from fasting.
Okay, I don't think you're reading the right one.
I'm reading
the
right one.
Bro, I'm not talking to you. I'm talking to her. So don't interrupt.
But you were doing that to me.
Don't interrupt.
It's the same thing.
The hadith. Can you read? Wait. Who narrated it? No. What you're talking about? Who narrated it?
Doesn't show who narrated it in this place.
narrated Abu Sa'id al-Khudri.
Same ayah, same hadith.
He's talking about the ayah, he's talking about the hadith.
Okay, go on, yeah. Then? You're talking about the ayah.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. Ayah and the hadith, same idea. There's a reason that is the conclusion.
It's talking about Naqs al-Din.
Naqs al-Din, she's Muslim. Yeah, and when she gets her period, she's exempt from praying and she's exempt from fasting.
So are you saying, so, you're saying in the period she forgets?
No. We'll get to that step, yeah, Habibi.
I'm trying to understand you. Yeah? But what are you saying? Explain to me. Go on. What's your name, by the way?
Yeah, my name is Isa.
Isa, yeah?
Yes.
Daniel.
That's Jesus' name.
Yeah.
Jesus' name.
Anyway, go on.
Yeah. Another reason why you should follow Joshua.
Okay, no, Yeshua.
Women,
anyway, that's a
different
one.
Might forget.
Isa means Joshua. Yeah. That's a different one.
Women might forget, they're more likely to forget. Then, that's good. When it says Naqs al-Din, it means that when she gets away, she's exempt from praying and she's exempt from fasting. So she does not fast and pray as much as the man.
Because she forgets.
No, because she gets her period, she's exempt.
Okay, because she's only her period,
she's exempt
from praying.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
What has period got to do with praying?
No, actually, let me say something.
I'm asking him.
It's confusing.
No, but
what you are talking about, he's not talking about that one. That's why you are confusing here.
No, I'm not.
Wait. You quoted Ayah Surah Al-Baqarah.
Ayah 282.
This has nothing to do with period. This has to do with witness.
We know that.
No. He's saying that the reason we need two women for the shahada of one man.
Yeah.
And
wait, Omari, he's explaining.
But there is coming too. Naqs al-aql wa din. It is in the same hadith.
Yeah.
Aql, which is more likely to forget. And din, which is because naqs al-din. Why is she naqs al-din?
But why is she more likely to forget? Why?
Well, women in general are more likely to forget.
Why?
Ask this men is just that. I don't know.
Let me tell you why.
Why?
Your prophet said it.
Yeah.
Sahih al-Bukhari, volume 3. No. Volume 3, book 48, number 826.
Yeah.
Narrated, I read it earlier on, I'll read it again. Abu Sa'id al-Khudri, the prophet said, isn't the witness of a woman equal to half of that a man? The woman said it, yeah? To the prophet, yeah? The prophet said that. And the woman said, yes. And then the prophet said, this is because of the deficiency of her mind.
Yes.
What does deficiency?
And religion. Continue the hadith.
And religion, yeah. That's another hadith.
And deen.
This is a different one. Yeah.
No, it's the same hadith.
Science is there's a woman and a man.
So what does deficiency mean? What does deficiency mean?
Deficiency. Yes, I'll tell you why it's deficient. If I pray for 1 month, 30 days, 5 times a day, a woman has a period for 5 days, she is exempt. This is a privilege for the woman. She is tired, she's having cramps. You don't know, I've just read it to you, but you weren't.
No. It's Sahih al-Bukhari.
I think you won't have problem with the deen. You won't have problem with
Omar,
that.
Naqsat aql wa deen. Then?
I don't have a problem with that, but Muhammad didn't say she's deficient because she's going to have periods. He didn't say
that. That is why.
He's not saying that.
That is why. That is why. Explain. In the hadith, that the reason that she is deficient in her deen.
No, it's not in deen. Forget it, he will agree on deen. It's
aql. She's likely to forget.
Because he did say, Muhammad said it. Another narration, Muhammad said she's deficient in mind and religion.
No, there is also
a reason. No, but you won't have problem in religion because when she's bleeding, she's not allowed to fast or.
I do have a problem with that.
Okay, no problem.
Our Christian women, they can pray and fast anytime.
Okay, no problem.
There's no problem.
Okay.
But there's a limitation in Islam
where
your biology is associated with prayer.
Yeah.
It doesn't make sense.
It does.
God is completely separate from your biology.
In Islam, that's not
clean. Or in the period of preterium.
Clean in Islam.
We know that. But it's got nothing to do with your relationship with God.
No, that's Islam. No, forget about that. You know,
that's what I'm saying. In Islam, it's wrong.
So the question is the aql, they forget.
Women are more likely to forget.
Where did we get? No problem, why? They have deficient mind.
No.
That's what your prophet said here, I just read it. No, deficiency. Sahih al-Bukhari.
Deficiency, when you translate it like that.
Yeah, the word naqis, he uses right, naqis. Yeah. The Arabic word is the way you are reading. Naqis.
Naqis means deficiency. She is more like forget.
What does deficient mean?
Reduce.
It means lower, isn't it? So exactly, that's what I'm saying to you.
No, no. Like, lower the aql in deen, like, it's more likely to forget. And in deen, she is exempt from prayer at certain times of her life. Period, or the period of purpurium. You know that? Okay,
Isa,
after
Isa, but we don't have this problem in Christianity. Our women in Christianity, they don't have to have any limitations in prayer to God. Whether they're on the period or not.
No, Omar, you see, the prayer in Christianity and Islam is different. We are talking about daily five prayers.
No, I'm saying, you can pray 15 times a day in Christianity. There's no limit.
There is no limit in Islam. You can pray as much as you want.
Okay, but the pillars are five times a day.
The pillars are five.
Okay, wait.
This is the minimum.
Omar, wait.
This is the minimum. You want to do more? Go ahead.
What I'm saying to you is, if you're bleeding,
can you go to the church?
You can even pray more to God.
No. You mean dua? The way we can do dua.
The dua and this.
We can do dua. Oh God, Ya Allah, Subhanahu. Thank you very much for what you have blessed me. And bless me with this shot. This is
so what can dua. You not do? What can the woman do?
Example, the
salat.
Salat.
Exactly. So salat. What is salat?
No. Dua, salat, different.
The prayer.
But is salat, who is she talking to?
No, it's different.
Who is she talking to in salat?
No, it's different.
Why is it different?
Okay, why is it different? What you guys dua, do why we call dua, is like asking God help. You need a job, you need a family problem. This,
you call it
there's
prayer,
no time, anytime you can do it, anyway.
Okay, but...
But the salah, the five-day prayer...
She can do that.
...has to be with a time, and you have to do that ablution washing, you have to face the qibla. There's a rule based on that.
Okay,
but... She's not allowed to do that.
It's still prayer, though. Still prayer, you know.
We call it prayer in Islam. It's different name is used.
No, salat is prayer. Salat means prayer.
No.
Okay.
What does salat mean?
No. We have different forms of prayer. We have many forms of worship.
Salat has been translated in English as a prayer. Dua has been translated as a prayer. But in Arabic, in Islam, salat and the dua are different. Do you understand? Is the translator
made? No, they're different in your approach. That one you have to have physical cleaning to do salat.
And then you have to...
The other one you can do anytime you want.
Yeah.
So there are two kinds of ways to speak to your God. It doesn't make sense.
No. Dua is when I ask God for something.
Yeah.
It's about me. Salat.
Anytime. I mean,
worship God.
Do you understand?
Okay.
So, salat
is compulsory.
Let's see if you guys are consistent. If you guys are bleeding somewhere, can you do salat?
Bleeding like an injury.
Yeah.
There's a rule for that.
Can you go salat?
We are talking about
spirit blood.
We are talking about period.
We are not talking about blood cutting.
We are talking about period.
By the way, if you're currently bleeding, you can't do salat. You are bleeding actively. You can't
if you are bleeding, can you
so
go to
is
the
there's a limitation with Allah. There's a big limitation with Allah. You have to be like not bleeding.
Do you know what it's like to have a period?
I'm not a woman.
Let me ask you, our friend. You've been here with us for a long time.
Yeah. Can you pray in your period?
No.
But you can. She's a Christian woman. Who can pray in her period?
Who says
no problems.
Who says you can pray with your?
The Bible says it. You can pray at any time, anywhere.
Daniel, Habibi, Daniel. Let's just ask her. Do you feel tired? If we said that during your period you have to get up five times a day, you have to wash, you have to go, and you have to pray, isn't it a bit exhausting? Okay? God has given you a pass during this 5 to 7 days of the month, has given you, say, okay, we understand that you might be tired. Please relax. You don't have to pray.
Don't worry about
you don't need to pray. Relax. Enjoy. We need.
She's not gonna do her shahada. Don't worry.
Huh?
No. It makes sense.
If she doesn't want to, it's fine.
There was in the UK here. They wanted to make a law: a woman who is bleeding shouldn't go to work. They were debating here because it's too much pain, too much this, too much depression.
When you are in pain, that's when you go to God more.
Yeah.
Do you know that? He's the one that
you
created
can
it in
do,
them anyway.
You can do dua.
So when you're in pain, that's when you go to God more and
dua.
He gives you peace.
Yeah, you make dua. God, I am in pain. Please help me.
Yeah, but there's two types of prayers in Islam.
No! You see the word prayer
is
translated in two different names in Arabic.
Salat she can't do.
Salat and dua doesn't even look like same.
I'm not saying they are.
Yeah, so that
I'm saying there are two types of prayers in Islam.
To us, dua is asking.
Exactly.
Dua is asking God for something.
I know, yes.
Oh God, please give me this.
Yeah.
Oh merciful God, give me, I want a new car, I want a new job, I want to graduate. Yeah? This is asking God for something. Then, and God wants you to ask Him. Ask me. Yeah, and be thankful for what I give you. Yeah? But prayer is something that you, it's compulsory to do.
Whoa, I'm trying to understand. When you're asking God, are you praying?
We call it dua.
Yeah, but what is that?
It's asking God for something.
But you're not praying. You're not praying.
Asking.
It is a form of worship.
But asking,
yes.
Prayer is asking as well.
Salat
no.
In Islam.
When we pray, Salat. It's not asking. When we go to the mosque, that 5 daily prayer,
yeah, you just
we are
recite,
not asking.
You just recite the Quran, isn't it?
Exactly.
Okay, we know that.
Yeah.
But it's got nothing to do with
we are not God
intimacy that. With your God.
When
nothing.
We finish prayer, in the 5...
In Christianity,
yeah.
I'm comparing Christianity and Islam. In Christianity,
well.
Yeah, you can pray at any time, anywhere, at any situation.
You can do
Islam
that in Islam.
Well.
No, you can do the salat. The salat that you're saying. The salat that you're saying, a woman can do it in her period.
No.
In our religion, if you want to call it religion,
but
we can. A woman can do her prayers. Yeah. Not just ask.
Okay.
For a car, for a house, she can pray to me.
Is it our blood? Is it our blood? No. Wait, brother. Is it our blood clean in Christianity? Is the blood clean? Woman's period, is it clean?
Why are you asking me that?
I'm asking you. If you can go to
we don't associate that with prayer with God.
No. If it's clean,
you do.
If it's clean, that means you can come to the church. You can do all the things.
Other than the cleanliness, yes,
the cleanness is by the blood of Jesus Christ.
So that
if he cleans you, it doesn't matter the period that a woman is going through. She's clean.
Is it the blood?
But physically, it doesn't matter what happens.
It's not about the period being dirty or clean. Okay, we understand that it's not as hygienic as everything else. But however, it is a time, she's tired. She's losing blood. Men, we won't be able to suffer what women suffer.
Actually,
let's be honest.
Yeah. Because women tell men how do they suffer.
If we had periods, we've been sick.
I know that.
When we become sick, we become the biggest babies in the world.
That's why they need to go to God more.
Yeah.
That's why they need to go to God more.
If you want, God help me, give me strength to go through this. Yes, you can do that. But if you want to get up and pray, you don't need to do that. Please relax, enjoy, have a nice time. You're already in pain. Take care of yourself. Huh?
I just see it as a limitation.
It's not a limitation. You are giving a free pass. If I said 5 days a month or 1 week out of the 4 weeks per month, don't come to work.
For women,
have a days off.
Every month,
I won't take the days off.
2 weeks at minimum, and then their deen is free.
Okay.
You don't need to worry about your...
With the witnesses part we talked about.
Daniel. The tables have turned a bit.
Because
I want to know.
That's why I said that.
You guys are going like this.
Daniel, we
should
not
worry about that. The witnesses part.
Why do you need two women for one man? Yeah? Because Muhammad said a woman's mind is deficient. We showed it, yeah? And you said, yeah, a woman is low. What do you mean by that? Wait, he said it.
I translated the deficient is naqas. Naqas.
And you said they're lower.
Yeah, naqas.
What do you mean? Just expand.
Naqas.
No, wait, let him do it. Because he said it, not you.
It means less.
Less than the man.
Exactly.
Do you agree with that?
I don't agree.
Why not?
When you said naqs, she's missing. She's more likely to forget. She's more likely to forget.
So she's not less.
The word naqas.
The woman in Islam is generally, she's not lower than a man.
No,
they're both on equal terms.
Huh?
Yes, she's not lower than.
Wait, he's just saying.
No. You are talking about it.
More likely to forget.
He's talking about in general.
Here, there's a disagreement here. I want you guys to agree before we talk.
Daniel, ya habibi. What he's saying.
He's talking in general. Man and woman are equal. But actually, we are not equal because we have differences.
Men are smart.
Even men and men are not equal. We have differences. You understand?
No. This specific one is the witnesses. The witnesses. Do you believe that in the witnesses the woman is lower than the man?
Okay, I tell you, I tell you something.
Than men.
The reason
Daniel. Do you believe they are lower than the man?
The reason.
When we said she is missing, the reason. She's deficient. You mean what deficient
wait,
is?
Wait, the reason is
more likely to forget.
Exactly.
And then the other reason about the naqsa deen, yeah, she's deficient in her deen, in her religion, does not mean that men are generally more better at worshiping God. Yeah, but because that the woman
is exempt. The reason why two women is in the ayah. It says, "Inta dil idahuma fatuzakir idah." If the order come to forget, the order will remind the order. That's the reason.
But why is it not equal with the man? So the man woman, never forgets. The man never forgets. The woman is the only one. The man never forgets.
The woman is more likely to forget.
But the man never forgets. How about if the man forgets? What happens?
Yeah, that's why you have two men. Two men or three women?
No, that's it. It says one man and
two. No.
It's not about equality.
Two men.
It's not about equality. Men and women have different characteristics, right or wrong.
It doesn't say that. No, I'm reading what the Quran says.
And I'm not talking about the
Quran. Quran is not a medical book.
I'm talking about science. Talking about science.
But I don't want to talk about science. I want to talk about what religion says.
The Quran complements everything that you see in life.
No, it doesn't.
It does.
No, it doesn't.
Fine.
No, it doesn't.
I'm asking you a question.
Without diverting, yeah?
I'm asking you a question. Women and men, don't they have different characteristics?
They do.
I agree with that.
Fine.
But what did
you
Muhammad
my question.
Say? What
you
did Muhammad say
you
about women?
My question. My next question is...
You're asking the questions that are not relevant here.
That are making you silent.
The reason is...
Sorry?
That are making you silent. You're...
Because it's not relevant. Yeah, if it's relevant, then I can respond to it.
My point will reach. You will see the relevance.
Give them a shot.
You will see irrelevance. They're different. So they have different characteristics. Which means that they each have roles that one can do better than the other.
Yeah.
Right? And that is why the Quran says what it says in different...
No. But hey, see, when it says naqs al-aql wa deen, yeah.
You don't even know the ayah. All right.
I know the ayah.
When it says naqs al-aql wa deen,
I'm talking about in general.
Okay, but in general, will men forget ever?
Of course.
That's why you need two men. Two men or one man.
What happens when men forget in Islam?
Let me see the ayah.
Brother, wait. I'm asking him.
In what situation?
Your phone, take it out.
In what situation?
Any situation. Any situation. If you want witnesses, that's
not one man. It's two men.
What happens if you want witnesses for something?
Yeah.
And then the man forgets.
It's not one man.
He doesn't know.
Daniel, it's not one man. Say for example.
In Islam,
yeah. Umar like needs us in as witnesses. Either me or you, or you and like two women, because then there will be three of you. Or there's two of us. If you forget, I'm here.
Yeah,
if I forget,
what does Islam say?
Islam says either two men or one man and two women. Yes, that's what it says.
One man and two women.
Yeah, pull the ayah again.
Two men or one man and two women.
Okay, what about... Are you answering the question?
Yes.
Are you answering the question?
Yes, yeah? I'm asking the question.
Because Muhammad clearly says about what the women do.
Wait. I think
how they
in order to establish the connection first we need to make sure that it means two men are our witnesses or one man and two women. It's not with just one man or just two women. Yeah? And the second part is, if we go on to the hadith, when we say she is deficient in mind and religion, yeah, it doesn't mean that she is mentally deficient. She's just more likely to forget. So there are two plans.
If she forgets, yeah. The other will remind the other.
But it says here, deficiency of a woman's mind.
No, this is...
It is a literal translation.
It's the same thing.
The deficiency is that she might forget. She's more likely to forget.
Yeah, but there's
which
nothing
is a normal
about
physiology
the man.
Of women.
What, give women me what... Okay, give me what Muhammad said about the man forgetting.
Yeah?
What did Muhammad say if a man forgets? He's talking about here when... No. Muhammad's saying here, yes. When women forget, yeah?
That because he's answering the question of the word the woman asked.
Exactly. So, is there any reference where a man comes and asks Muhammad?
There are many hadiths where men come and ask Muhammad.
About witnesses. in regards to witnesses, if the man forgets or not.
I don't know, but we don't need a hadith for every possible
There isn't.
Situation.
I'll tell you now, there isn't.
Okay, well, look, there are many hadiths of men coming asking the Prophet about many things.
But, yeah, but about this one, this specific one, I'm trying to compare man and woman about witnessing.
He's not going to answer like every possible situation and give us a book that is instead of 600 pages, we're going to give it 10 million pages and it gets an update every year. And then Sharia will come in and say, when the iPhone comes out, buy the iPhone, don't buy the Samsung. Because the iPhone has.
The Sharia does not have an answer for a man forgetting. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, no, it does. It does. That's why you need two men.
You don't have.
That's why you need two men.
What did Muhammad say? Muhammad, your prophet.
Yes.
What did he say about a man forgetting? That's my question now.
There's no man who came and asked him about forgetting. I don't know. Search about it.
So why is just about the woman?
Okay, we can take it in another context where a man came and asked the prophet about something. And we can say that no woman came and asked him about it, so that does not apply to women.
About sex maybe, yeah?
No.
That's why you guys, you Muslim, I wouldn't say you, but Islam, it's more about the man than the woman. Everything. It's about the man's right. In Surah 2, 223, what does it say? Go into your woman as if she's your tilth. You know what tilth is? It's in the farmland where you just tilth the farm. You can go into her anytime you want to. Why doesn't the Quran talk about man like that?
You can't go to her anytime you want.
That's what it says.
You cannot have sex
Surah 2? Bleeding. Surah 2. Okay. Can you explain Surah 2, 223?
No. You don't say you anytime because the Quran is clear. Time.
Okay, show
the
me.
The time you can approach your wife and the time you can approach to her.
Instead of talking, let me read it. Before we wrap up.
This is what you are talking about. Is when you are having sex with her, tell you how to do it. But you are talking about time. I'm saying.
Let's see what it says.
Well, I understand. Part
223. Bakra again.
Yeah,
223.
I know the verse you are saying.
Do you? Are you sure you know?
I know.
What does it say?
You are talking about. Where God says the way to approach your wife.
Yeah.
You are saying anytime, but the ayah is not saying anytime.
Here, it does. Your women are a tilt for you. Yeah. So come to your tilt whenever you like. Whenever you like. I'm reading your Quran. And send ahead for yourself to be God weary. And know that you will encounter him and then
your wives are a place messed up. This is another translation. Your wives are a place of sowing of seed. You come to your place of cultivation. However you wish and put forth before yourselves and fear Allah. Fear Allah that you will meet him and give you time.
You fear Allah, but the woman is a cultivation.
No,
the
woman
is a wife. That's what it says.
It's saying it's a place of sowing your seed. Which is a form of reading.
Your wives are a place of sowing seed for you. So come to your place of cultivation.
Sowing your seed.
So that's a woman.
Sowing your seed.
No.
When he says the
first.
No.
By the way,
this is one ayah about witnessing. When he says that, the Prophet is saying here.
The second word is.
When he says something is the root of my love. When you say that, sowing your seed is about cultivation. When a man and woman get together, what happens? Exactly. They get a baby.
This is in the bed.
It's a baby.
Exactly. So can a woman go into a man whenever she wants?
Her man. No. Her man. Her husband.
No, even her husband. When she's bleeding, when she eats it off.
No, there are certain times.
Sorry?
There are certain times. Yeah.
But here it's not about the time. It's about when you have.
I just read it. I read it here.
Yeah, I'm reading it here.
I read it here. It says whenever you want to go into your
time in Arabic.
It doesn't mean time. It doesn't mean time.
In the action, how do you do it?
Okay, so she's your tillage. Yeah. Go into her whenever you want to. And then it says, fear Allah.
No. It is a place of sowing your seed.
Where is the same verse to a woman?
You deposit your seed inside the uterus of the woman.
Where is it to the woman?
Sorry? Have sex whenever they want. It's like,
okay, but
what do you say?
This is referring to the man.
No, he's not saying
to the woman.
Daniel, there is a problem in the Bible.
But does it say the same thing to the man about the woman? Can the woman do the same thing?
I'm sure it can. Because
can the woman?
Yeah, sure.
Where in the Quran does it say?
No, you see,
it doesn't need to say that.
Doesn't make a difference.
Does it
need to say for the man?
So what if my wife came to me and says, "Hello, honey, I want to have intercourse with you," I'll say no. you're being crude, khas, and just dismiss her. No, that doesn't make sense. That's the idea that you have, but it's not true. Yeah?
Isa,
yeah.
This is talking about for the man.
Yeah.
You can go into the woman anytime you want. There is no ayah in the Quran that says... No, I don't want that. I want an ayah that says the same thing to the woman about the
husband. Okay. Let's finish this, yeah?
There's no equality, that's what it is. But in Jesus Christ, we have equality.
Repent and accept Christ. Give me a verse in the Bible. Where man, woman is...